Boy, the day's cooling off fast. I like this. Didn't take long. Every day that we spend seeking God in some way, whether it be with devotions or Bible study, whether it be in prayer or meditating on His Word, or even sometimes just calling out to God because you're so sad or so desperate that you can't do anything else, God meets you there. He cares for you. When you have opportunity, though, and you can build upon your faith, then you should take the time to get together with people that share a common faith with you, that if it's who knows what you may be into, whatever it may be, then if Jesus is there, then you should share it with other people and be encouraged to learn on your own and develop a personal Bible study and growth so that you can get to know who God is and what He's doing in your life. And as you do, then God will direct you in different places to help other people to get to know Jesus too. Because you see, it's not as though one person is right and everybody else is wrong. It's more like God works in different ways with different people to bring them to a knowledge of His Son. In Spurgeon, "The daughter of Jerusalem has shaken her head at thee. Reassured by the word of the Lord, the poor trembling citizens of Zion grew bold and shook their heads at Sennacherib's boastful threats. Strong faith enables the servants of God to look with calm contempt upon their most haughty foes. We know that our enemies are attempting impossibilities. They seek to destroy the eternal life which cannot die while Jesus lives, to overthrow the citadel against which the gates of hell shall not prevail. They kick against the pricks to their own wounding and rush upon the bosses of Jehovah's buckler to their own hurt. We know their weakness. What are they but men? And what is man but a worm? They roar and swell like waves of the sea, foaming out their own shame. When the Lord arises, they shall be as chaff before the wind, be consumed as crackling thorns. Their utter powerlessness to do damage to the cause of God and His truth may make the weakest soldiers in Zion's ranks laugh them to scorn. Above all, we know that the Most High is with us, and when He dresses Himself in arms, where are His enemies? If He cometh forth from His place, the potsherds of the earth will not long contend with their Maker. His rod of iron shall dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel, and their very remembrance shall perish from the earth. Away then all fears, the kingdom is safe in the King's hands. Let us shout for joy, for the Lord reigns. His foes shall be as straw for the dunghill." So often I keep hearing of all these people that want to save the church or save this or save that, and God's in control. God knows what He's doing. God at any moment in time could rescue, deliver, save, cause repentance, revival, salvation, restoration. All those things that are needful that the body of Christ, when their peculiar members sit back and think that the world is coming to an end for them, God has it in His plan and His perfection, working out our salvation to create for us an opportunity to be made of like mind, to trust in Him with all our heart, to lean not in our own understanding, to all our ways acknowledge Him and let Him direct our path, so we would not be caught up into the world and its anxieties and fears and worries, but rather we could know that God is in control. Do you know that God is in control? Is He in control? Or are you exercising self-control over your own life, that you are directing the way you should go, and you're finding that it's not working out so well? Sometimes it's just a question of giving Him the opportunity to prove to you that He knows what He's doing. Do you? Thank you.